Uganda's plans to extract oil has been at the center stage in the recent weeks. This follows a resolution passed by the European Parliament urging Uganda and Tanzania to forfeit the plans of constructing of the East African crude oil pipeline, citing environmental concerns and human rights abuses.
Was 78% nitrogen, 21% oxygen, then something small about carbon dioxide. Now it seems the percentage of carbon dioxide is increasing because of too much emission.
While officiating at the 7th Uganda International Oil and Gas Summit 2022 today in Kampala, President Museveni said members of the European Union cannot lecture Uganda on its interests.
And these goods must be competitive in the market. And if the goods are to be competitive in the market, they must be good quality but cheap. So therefore, we cannot undermine ourselves by promoting expensive energy, which will undermine our industrialization plan.
According to President Museveni, Uganda and East Africa are capable of handling their regional matters. The president emphasized that Uganda's oil and gas plan will be implemented according to schedule.
We, apart from the market of Uganda, we have been working, and when we came into government, of course, we pushed, and we created the East African community, revived it, it had collapsed. So therefore, when you talk of the market, you have the 43 million people, you have the East African community, 300 million now, you have COMESA, and we have negotiated for the CFTA.
President Museveni has encouraged oil companies to go ahead with the refinery and the pipeline.
I encourage the oil companies to move on the two, on the refinery and on the pipeline.
The summit attracted over 400 stakeholders in the oil and gas sector from the African continent and Europe. The energy minister assured stakeholders of the country's move to conserve the environment and reduce carbon emissions in the oil exploration. The minister also appreciated Ugandans for having responded in the timely manner when the EU Parliament passed a resolution against the oil and gas projects.
The discovered crude oil and gas is being commercialized through the refinery and the crude oil pipeline, whose development is progressing very well. And we are remained focused, and I want to thank you, Your Excellency, for having come out timely when the European Parliament passed the motion that they passed against development in Uganda.
She said oil activities have already caused infrastructure development, and the sector is expected to generate more income from the country.
Oil development has already caused infrastructure development in the oil and gas region and is expected to generate revenue for the country, which has already been ring-fenced in the law for infrastructure development. In the infrastructure, it includes electricity infrastructure.
The 7th edition of the Uganda International Oil and Gas Summit is aimed at harnessing Uganda's investment and growth. The summit attracts global attention, making it a significant meeting for Uganda's development plans by bringing together all stakeholders in the oil and gas sector. The two-day event is being attended by over 400 guests from across 125 national and international companies. Reports by Jaliet Namuwaya for the news.